Welcome to my presentation. My name is Rolf Westerteiger. I'm a senior software developer at Math the Market. I work on many different components in Geodict, and the AI subsystem is one of them. Okay. So I want to start by giving an overview of where we are using AI within Geodict. And I want to give you a small list of general and miscellaneous improvements that we made in the AI subsystem. Then I want to talk about the image quality enhancement feature inside ImportGeoWall, followed by the multi-channel segmentation feature. And then I want to talk about the new enhanced fiber identification model that we are shipping with FiberFind AI in Geodict 2024, followed by the non-woven digital twin GeoApp, which can help you generate training data for your custom neural networks. And finally, I want to conclude by showing you the artificial CT GeoApp. So first of all, an overview of where we are using AI methods within Geodict. In ImportGeoWall, we have the image enhancement feature, which you can use, for example, to enhance micro CT images, as we will see shortly. Then we have the image segmentation feature, which can be used together with either the UNet architecture or a boosted tree architecture in order to segment your image, given some example labels. Then in FiberFind and GrainFind, we have both fiber identification and binder segmentation powered by deep learning as well. And last but not least, we have the Geodict AI module, which primarily allows you to train your own custom neural networks for all of the other features, that is for object identification, material phase and binder segmentation, and for image enhancement. And if you're interested in the latter, feel free to visit my breakout session tomorrow talking about Geodict AI and how you can train your own custom neural network models. Now, some general improvements that we did. We switched the deep learning framework from TensorFlow to the more modern PyTorch framework. And at the same time, we supported the we added support for custom neural networks. So if you have a neural network written in PyTorch, basically you can plug it into Geodict and use it there. You can train your own networks in Geodict, and you can then apply it to your own images. Also, we added multi-GPU support for both training and inference. And we improved in Geodict AI for the training procedure, we improved the sampling randomization for improved convergence, and we got rid of the rather confusing sub-epoch concept. And for details about how we got rid of that, I advise you to visit my breakout session tomorrow as well. And finally, FiberFind AI also, the FiberFind AI statistics were expanded, and it now delivers information also about boundary contact points, which usually means fibers entering or leaving or entering the domain, which is, of course, especially useful if you're analyzing statistics for of materials with very long fibers, where the fibers are actually longer than the domain. So the first feature I want to talk about is image quality enhancement via deep learning. When taking samples with a micro CT, of course, there's always a compromise. You can either use a short exposure time for each projection, which means you get a higher sample throughput per day, but you also obtain noisy and low contrast images. On the other hand, if you take longer exposures or equivalently take many short exposures and average them, you have a long scanning time and you get a low throughput in samples per day, but you get a low noise, high contrast image. Now, what we did was we used deep learning techniques to train a network and to train a network that, given a low quality image, it will output a high quality image. So you get all the benefits of a short scanning time, but at the same time you get a high contrast image out of this network. In detail, what we did is we used paired low and high quality images. So for example, an image of the same sample where we have say 10 exposures per projection, and we only use one of these exposures, as a low quality image. We reconstruct only from one exposure per projection as a low quality image. And then we reconstruct from the average of 10 exposures for each projection to obtain a high quality image. So we have a registered pair of low and high quality images. And then we train a neural network. Basically, we train a function that maps the low quality image to a high quality image. So the left-hand image that you can see here is a low-quality scan. The center image is the high-quality scan. And the rightmost image is the geodict AI result applied on the low-quality image, on the low-quality image. As you can see, that reconstructed image even has less noise than the high-quality image. Next, we have multi-channel segmentation in import GeoVol. Here we have, as an example, a FIPSAM scan of an NMC 532 battery cathode, thanks to Zeiss. And the task here was to simulate conductivity with conductodict, diffusion with diffudict, and charge-discharge cycles with batterydict. And for this task, we needed to segment the images into a pore space, which is the void space in that image, the NMC particles, which are the bright, big gray particles, and the binder, which is the dark gray material in between the particles. And FIPSAM segmentation in general is difficult because each image slice, of course, contains a depth view into the material. So it also, so you can also see the slices following this slice shining through, basically. But we only care in segmentation, we only care about the foreground, basically the focus plane that we see at the very front. So with FIPSAM especially, we can make use of multiple image modalities if the instruments provides these. Two of these are secondary electrons 2, SE2, which gives us a good topographical resolution and a suppression of the background signal. So in the SE2 image, we see the focus plane more clearly than the background. And then there's ESB, energy selective backscattered, which on the other hand gives us a high contrast between different materials, especially if they have a different atomic number, which is the case here because the NMC and binder particles, as you can see, have a strong contrast in the ESB image. And in the SE2 image, as I said, we have a strong contrast between the foreground and the background of the sample. Now, what we can do in import GeoVol is make use of that information. The UNET-based segmentation in import GeoVol can now use multiple images. And as before, the user paints some example labels for each material phase, on the as you can see on the right-hand side. And you can switch between the ESB and the SE2 images for reference while doing that. And the UNET model is trained to predict these labels for the rest of the structure. But in contrast to before, now in that training, all the loaded volume fields, both of these channels are considered, and the UNET automatically learns to extract the relevant information to label the material correctly. And of course, this also works with any other multimodal imaging techniques which give you aligned images. So for example, dual energy CT images would also work in the same way. For the results, you can see here, again, the SE2 image with a good background separation and the ESB image with a good material contrast. And in the gray images on the upper right corner, you can see a blob of dark gray binder material. And you can see in the upper right zoomed image that a segmentation based only on a single channel, based only on SE2 image, made some classification errors. As you can see, all this material up there should be blue, but it classified some of these voxels actually as active material. And in the picture below that, where we use the dual channel segmentation, where the information from both the SE2 and the ESB image was considered, you can see that the binder was classified correctly. Feature also related to this is the so-called magic brush, which speeds up the labeling process. So again, we import an image of an NMC 532 cathode. We activate the magic brush function, which pre-computes a clustering, as you can see in the second image. And this, of course, accelerates the labeling process because now you can click onto these individual clusters or islands, and they are automatically assigned to the material phase that you're currently painting. And in the left picture, you can then see that the boosted tree algorithm based on the labels provided in the third image then completes the labeling of this image slice. Next, we have an enhanced fiber identification model, which is now shipped with FiberFind AI and replaces the two previously shipped models. And as you can see in the table below, this model is now anisotropic. It works for any fiber orientation, while the previous models had a preference for fibers oriented in the XY plane. It also works for elliptical cross-sections, while the previous models were only trained with circular cross-sections. And it works with a larger diameter range, with fibers of up to 26 voxels of diameter. And it also does not require that the diameter be constant along the fiber. And this leads to a better prediction of fiber length distribution. You can see here where we have applied the network to a composite example. And there was also an experiment done where the fiber length was actually experimentally determined. And we can see a good match between the FiberFind AI statistics result and the experiment. Next, we have the non-woven digital twin GeoApp by my colleague Andreas Grieser, and he also has a presentation about that. And previously, the problem was generating a digital twin of a non-woven was a lot of manual work because it was difficult to match the curvature and the curliness of the material sample that you're trying to reproduce. This non-woven digital twin GeoApp now allows you to take a segmented micro-CT scan of a non-woven, run FiberFind on it, load these FiberFind results into that app, and that app will then, via an automatic optimization loop, find all those missing parameters that you need to input into FiberGeo in order to reproduce a statistical digital twin of your structure. And as you can see down here, that the permeability, the flow simulation results match quite well between the sample and the digital twin. And on the right-hand side, you can also see that the fiber curvature distribution matches, which was previously tricky to reproduce. Here again, you can see the original sample and the digital twin. Of course, this is a statistical digital twin, so the fibers don't have to be in the same position, but the characteristics that you care about have to be the same. And it also can take a couple of hours, but that's a couple of hours computer time, not a couple of hours of your time, so that's much better. And last but not least, we have the artificial CT scan geo app written by Andreas Weber. This allows you to create artificial CT scans based on geometry models. So you have your normal binarized or digital model generated by Geodict, and you can use this app to produce a synthetic CT image. And this can be used for visualization and testing and validation of image filters. And one interesting thing that we're working on right now, which is work in progress, is to actually use this for training of neural networks, which will finally mean that you don't have to segment your images anymore, because you can basically train the whole workflow. You can train a neural network to start with a CT image and output the fibers directly without you having to segment anything. That's the goal there.